Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to map one Java object into another. Because we know object mapping is a process of transforming data from one object into another. So in Java it can be a tedious task, require a lot of boilerplate to map data between two objects with different structure. So fortunately, there is a powerful library called Model Mapper that simplifies the object mapping process and provides a lot of flexibility in customizing the mapping behavior and also reduce the boilerplate code to map the data between two objects with different structure. Okay, let's see in the code how to use Model Mapper library to map one object into another object. So here we can see I have already created one Spring Boot application, and in this Spring Boot application I have created two REST endpoint, both are post mapping. So here I am passing as user request and returning the response as a user response, that is different model. And here I am passing user request as a request parameter and getting the response as a employee object. But before using Model Mapper, we need to add one maven dependency in our pom.xml file. So first we need to add Model Mapper maven dependency in our pom.xml file. So here I have added this maven dependency org.modelmapper. Model Mapper version is 3.11, that is latest. So here we can go in our user controller class. From user controller class, if I will go to our service layer, that is user service, so here what we need to do, first we need to convert our user request into user entity. After that we can send for save request. Once the record will be saved into DB, then we will get back entity user entity as a response object. But here we are not interacting with any database, so I have just typed one save method, that is simple returning user entity back. And here what I am doing, here we are converting user entity response into user response object. So if we want to convert our user request into user entity, what we need to do, we need to create user entity object here. So without Model Mapper we do like this. So here we need to write lots of lines of code, that we can say boilerplate code. So without Model Mapper library we do like this. User entity dot set name, and we will get from user request dot get name, like this. If there are 20 properties, then we need to write 20 times setter getter. So user entity dot set age, so we will get from user request dot get age, like this. For now I have just added three property in our model class, so here we are using only three setter getter method, set id, and from user request we will get id. If we have 30 or 40 plus property, then we need to write lots of lines of code, so it will increase the lines of code in our class. So to reduce these types of lines of code, we will go for Model Mapper entity, Model Mapper library. So this method will convert our user request into user entity. Then we will save this user entity into database. After that, we need to convert our user entity response into our user response model that we want to response to client. So here we again need to write lots of lines of code, like we will create user response object here. User response, new user response, and here we again need to write setter getter method for each property. For now we have only three properties, so it's less. So set age, user entity dot get age, user response dot set id, user entity dot get id, user response dot set age, user entity dot get age. So now we have done. So here we will return user response, and from here we will return user entity. So okay, let's start my application and see the response. Run as Java application. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. This is our REST endpoint that we have created, localhost 8080, and slash user is mapping that we have done here at our controller class. So here we can see this is user mapping. Now I will call this REST endpoint, and here we can see the response ID 1, name null, age 85. So let's see in the code why name is null. So we will go here in our service class. Okay, so here we have set the set age 2 times. So here we need to use set name, and here we will call get name method. So now we will get valid response. Okay, let's stop the application and start it again. So here we can see our application has started port number 8080. Let's go to Postman and call to this REST endpoint. So here we can see we are getting the response ID 1, name NN, age is 85. So let's go back, and in our user service IMPL we can see we need to write lots of setter and getter method to map one object into another object. So to reduce these types of lines of code, model mapper library came into picture. And with the help of model mapper library, we can reduce all lines of code from here. Okay, let's see how model mapper library works. So first I have created here model mapper object at class level. Then now here I will remove all these from here. And here I will just use model mapper dot map method. And inside map method, we need to pass two parameters. First is our request parameter. So we want to convert our user request into which model we want to convert. We want to convert into user entity. So here I will call user entity dot class object. So here I have done. So like this we can go for again. So I will just copy from here, and here we need to convert our user entity into user response. So here I will copy user entity, and we need to pass as a first parameter, and in which model we want to convert, we just need to define here which class we want to convert. So these are done. So now I will stop my application and check if it is working or not. So now I will run this application again. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Let's go to Postman and call the same REST endpoint again. And here we are getting the same response back. But now here we can see we have reduced the lines of codes. So here only one line is enough to convert one model into another model. And model mapper also provide different types of mapping strategy. So that can be used to customizing the mapping behavior. So some of the available strategies include loose, strict, and standard. Okay, let's see in the code how we can apply this strategy. So here we can go, and here we just need to call model mapper dot get configuration method, and from get configuration method we need to use set matching strategies, and here we will get matching strategies in them. Matching strategies dot loose, and like this we can use different strategies like strict. If we'll just match the exact match if we are using strict, but if we are using loose strategy, then if our method containing age and another method is get user age, then it will match with loose strategy. But with strict it will match the exact method get age with set age only. So like this we can use different strategies. So okay, let's see Here we can see our user request model have the properties ID, name and age, and our user entity have also same properties ID, age and name. But if we have to convert these user entity into another model like employee, so here we have different property like ID, employee name and employee age. If we want to convert into these, then what we need to do? So this is a challenge, how to make the mapper maps property whose name is source and destination are different, and how to perform some operation to return customized value. So here we have two different classes, one is user request and another is employee. Okay, let's see how to convert our user into employee. So here I have created one more restraint point, that is employee response. So inside get employee response, I am passing the parameter as user request and returning employee as a response to our client. So if I will go to our service IMPL class, so here first I am converting our user request into user entity model, and after converting, so here it will use the same method that we have already used. So next what we are going, we are just saving our user entity into database and getting the response from database as the entity response. Then next what we are doing, so here we can see we are converting our user entity response into our employee model. So let's see how to convert our user entity response into model. We can use setter getter, but it will increase the lines of code, so that's why model mapper comes into picture to reduce the lines of code. Okay, let's see how to use model mapper. So here what we need to do, we need to convert type map object. So here we can see I have created here type map object. So here I have passed user entity because I want to convert user entity into employee object. And how we can create, we need to call model mapper dot create type map function, and here we need to pass user entity dot class to which class we want to convert and in which class, that is employee class. Then we need to use this type map method, and here we can call add mappings. And here we need to again pass user entity and employee object. Here we need to create property map object, and inside this we need to use setter getter. But here we can see there are lots of lines of code, but this is the way how we can convert our user entity into employee object using model mapper library. So okay, let's call to the second rest endpoint, that is employee. So I will start my application again. Okay, I will copy this rest endpoint URL, and here we can see our application has started. So we are just adding two properties, user request into employee. So here we will get ID as a null. So here I will call employee. And here we can see ID is one, employee name and employee age. So these are the different parameter names, ID, name as employee name and age as employee age. So that's all was about how to convert one object into another in Java using model mapper library. Thanks for watching this video.